I think 9/11 changed U.S. foreign policy dramatically in two ways. The first and more obvious way was in bringing the issue of terrorism in general and radical Islamist terrorism in particular to the forefront of the American foreign policy agenda. During the 1990s, specialists in terrorism had noted events like the First World Trade Center bombing, the Oklahoma City bombing, the Japanese cult Om Shinrikyo's subway attack, and they had started to worry about a new rise of very dangerous terrorists who had maximal goals, and we always worried about them gaining WMD. At the same time, there were some people in the Middle East or who studied the Middle East who were worrying increasingly about Islamic radicalism and Islamist radicalism, and people who were starting to turn not just from their obsession with nasty regimes in the Middle East, but focusing on the United States and the backers of the Middle Eastern order. And what 9/11 did was combine those trends and make everybody realize that it was the single most important challenge to American foreign policy. The combination of Islamist radicalism and large-scale massive terrorism with the mass casualty impact basically made everybody from top to bottom realize that this is what we had to focus on, and this really could hurt us in a way that only a few specialists had thought of before. The second thing it did, which was somewhat less obvious, is that it unleashed U.S. power on the world. This sounds a bit weird, but because the U.S. obviously was powerful beforehand. But during the 1990s, unlike what many people expected, the unipolar moment, as Charles Krauthammer put it in 1991, I believe, in Foreign Affairs, turned out not to be a short, temporary period of American dominance, but rather an ongoing and growing one. With the Soviet Union gone, the United States was at the top of the heap, but then during the decade of the 1990s, it actually lapped the rest of the world even more so. So it was even stronger in relative power terms in 2000 than it had been in 1990. And yet, because of domestic political constraints, the United States basically didn't use this power in major dramatic ways. The Clinton administration wasn't focused obsessively on projecting American power and wanted to keep within public limits. And so the American public didn't authorize a lot of things. What 9/11 did was basically have Congress and the American public give the executive branch a blank check to get the people who did this and make sure it didn't happen again. And that was, in effect, the keys to the bank account that essentially unleashed all of American power that had been building up and turned it into power projection capabilities, which resulted not just in the Afghanistan campaign, but in the Iraq campaign eventually, in the global war on terror, and in the massive deployment of American resources in power projection and an activist world role that wouldn't have been conceivable without the immediate trigger of a threat in the previous decade. The interesting point is that in both these trends, we overshot the mark. And in retrospect, we can see now that we didn't just get seized with the idea of radical Islamist terrorism, we got obsessed with it and spent the vast majority of our time and effort over the last decade chasing not just important threats, but almost chimeras and overreacting and screwing ourselves in the process. And we not only sort of unleashed American power, we squandered American power through its misapplication and misuse. And so the irony is that after a decade dealing with 9/11 and its aftermath, the United States is now coming back to its pre-9/11 concerns with a more chastened, less hubristic attitude, a declining power base, a domestic situation that's less fortunate than it was then, and we're trying to figure out how to reestablish ourselves, not just as a global liberal hegemon in the world at large, but also to renew our sources of strength and economic and fiscal health here at home. So it's been a sober decade that in the long run will be considered a detour from the path we were on before, that we're now getting back to somewhat now.